Hey guys, welcome to this tutorial on how to customize your new free Apex Legends custom banner that you can use while you're streaming, while you're recording videos. I think it really adds a lot to your stream, especially when newcomers come in to check out your gameplay. After I saw Nickmercs and his custom banner that he has that matches his branding so well, John C. Stout reached out to me and was like, hey man, can you figure out how to do that? And so after sitting down in After Effects and learning the process, I was able to give him something that I believe was possibly one of the best things that I've ever made for his stream setup. So I made a more simplistic version and I wanted to put it out for the community to look at, download, and see if they enjoy on their stream. To start off, you'll click the link in the description of this video and it should bring you to this Google Drive link to download the Apex Legends custom banner folder. You're just going to click on this and it'll zip it up right for you and it'll put it into your downloads folder. After it's downloaded, whichever folder it's downloaded to, mine saved to the desktop, you're going to right click on it and make sure that you have some type of extracting software on your computer. It's 2021. If you do not have WinRAR on your computer, then you need to get it. I'll leave a download link to that as well in the description. You'll right click on it and extract to its separate folder, and that'll give you a folder right here. You'll want to go inside of this folder and then hit the Apex Custom Banner After Effects save file. As the project file opens up, you can see that you are met with your banner. And first off, I just want to say that this is one of the most compact After Effects templates that I've ever made personally. To start off, let's just go down the line in this control layer here. You can edit the control layer from this area, or you can click on it and go up to Effect Controls. And this will show you the line color. Now the line color is specific to this line that goes around the banner. I believe it adds a little bit of flair to the banner as soon as it starts. To change the color of this line, all you're gonna do is go up to the color picker here. And I would recommend staying in kind of like the, not the harsh reds or the two whites, just right in the middle here up at the top. And any color is gonna give it that pastel and or neon look. Next is the color text. Same exact thing as the last one. I would also recommend for the color text choosing a very popping color, whether that be, you know, a yellow, a cyan, or a bright pink or a bright purple, just to give it that pop. The extrusion is the drop shadow to the text. The text glow is not really noticeable unless the text is coming in and out. You can see a tiny bit of change as there is a glow radius, which will add a little bit of depth to your banner. Same thing for the second glow. This is just an additional one as the colors are coming in. And then the background video color, you can change the color of it to match your branding that you have. All of these things combined, you can definitely create a good looking color palette that matches the branding that you have on your Twitch channel and or YouTube channel. One of my favorite things about this entire template is the light streaks. There's actually two inside of the hood of the After Effects template, but the light streaks are one of my favorite additions that just kind of add a little bit of pop to your name. Next, we'll go into replacing the text. You'll just click right here next to render me. It'll say replace text here. In here, you can see how the text comes in and comes out. To change this checkered background, if you'll click right here on toggle transparency grid, this will show a black background instead, just to help see what you're doing. To change the text, you're just gonna double click on the sample here and then you can type in whatever you want. I also left you an additional line in case your name is too long. This font that we have here is included in the pack inside of the footage tab. And so if you do not have this font downloaded, feel free to take that out of the footage tab or right click on it and click on install for all users, which actually, no, I'll show you that right now. Inside of the folder itself, you'll click on footage and right here where it says prime time, you're going to right click and click on install or install for all users. While we're here, this is kind of the behind the scenes of the template. It's very, very simple with our cutouts of the background and then the foreground. And also I did include this non-copyrighted background that actually plays behind, and that is the texture that goes along with your stroke here, which I'll show you. So as this is going, you can see the colors changing in this area along the edges, and that is the video. So if your name is too long and you have to use two lines, you'll notice that if you go back to the tab here that your name is kind of over your health and shield bar. To fix this, what you're going to do is go back into the text tab and make sure that this selection tool is selected. And then you're going to hold down shift and click on the bottom layer. You're basically, or just, you know, select both of them. You just want them both selected. And then you'll just move one of these while holding shift. That'll keep the ratio. And then you can make it smaller. As you see, we are gaining some space in between. And so I want to move this guy up. I think you guys will also have this Y grid, X grid, and Z grid going on to where you can just grab the Y and move it straight up. If you don't, let me control Z on that. And then to change it in this window here, you're gonna click on the arrow, the drop-down arrow next to sample two, and then you'll move the position of it up, which will be this middle slider here. You can also mess with the different orientations, the scale, whatever you want to mess with. It is all here ready for you to use. A problem that I just noticed if you use the second line is that in the beginning, you can see here that the sample just kind of holds, you know, in the beginning and it doesn't really look right. So I'm gonna do a little bit of troubleshooting with you guys right now and show you how to fix this. So inside of the template here, you can see that the animation happens on the actual text layers. And so you know that in your problem focus is going to be right here on your text layers. So since this guy has a starting position still in front of the camera, like the camera can still see sample, what you can do, this Z axis kind of brings the text forward and backwards. So towards us and then away from us. And so what you can actually do is in the beginning, if you scroll all the way to the beginning and then you pull this Z axis, I pulled it the wrong way if you go right, so you're gonna want to go left. If you pull all the way past the camera, then as it comes in, it's going to come in from out of sight. And so let's go check on the Render Me tab and let's see how that looks. Looks much, much, much better. So yeah, just in case you guys have that problem, that is how you fix it. Last thing that we're gonna wanna change, of course, is your logo. Now, I am not the greatest After Effects user. Sometimes people have it to where the logo is like directly in front of you when you click on this right here and all you have to do is change it. For us, we actually have to do a little bit of problem solving here. When you wanna change your logo, all you're gonna do is you're gonna go into your project tab up in the top left. And then you'll right click, import file. So I found a PNG of my logo and now it is in my project tab. So what you'll do is you'll just drag this in and you can put it over top or underneath this sample logo. We're gonna end up turning the sample logo off anyway. You can see that we don't know where the logo is. That's because it's hidden up in the middle of the frame. And so all you have to do is make sure that your selection tool is selected and then drag this logo all the way down. And then you're gonna grab one of these corners and you'll start to bring it in, kind of pinch it in. And you can see that we are not holding any type of ratio here. So you're gonna hold down shift and then drag down. And now, as you can see, our logo is in the exact place, almost basically where the other logo is. We can turn the other logo off and then we can head back to the Render Me tab and you can see that your logo is here. One of the things that you can see is that the ears are cut off at the top. It's just to keep everything in line with the banner, but you may be like, oh, well, I want the ears to be seen. All you have to do is come back over to the replace logo tab and then move it down a tiny bit. Everything is like directly, like you edit it in one tab and it, you know, updates in another. And so my apologies for not making this as easy as possible, but you will have to do some experimenting and then just some trying out new things to see what works and what doesn't. So now after customizing your banner, we'll now walk through the steps of exporting to finally get it on your stream. Make sure that the Render Me tab is selected down at the bottom, and then we're gonna go to Composition, Add to Render Queue. It should pop up as a current render, and so what we'll do is go to Lossless. And we're gonna change this to QuickTime, and then add RGB plus alpha. You can leave everything else the same. Click OK. Now we're gonna go to the output, which is not specified yet. We'll click it, and then we'll just choose a folder that we want it to go to. After you've chosen your folder, all you have to do is click render. After it renders whatever folder you rendered it to, it is now ready to be placed inside of OBS. Inside of OBS on your Apex scene, you're going to right click and then add a media source. Call it whatever you want. And then you'll choose a local file, and this file will be in whatever folder you put your render in. Make sure you click the loop option here and then click OK. And now you have your very own custom Apex banner that will work inside of Apex. You do not need to move it. You do not need to do anything. One side note, make sure that you are playing your Apex game in a 1920 by 1080 aspect ratio just to keep from any problems that you may have. Now, let's say you don't want to hold it inside of OBS and you want to place it in Stream Elements, for example. The main go-to and industry standard for streaming is to turn this file into a Webm file, which is also the equivalent of a video PNG, but very easy for web players to play it. Aconvert.com is a good website to choose. Just choose your file in whatever folder you uploaded it to. Hit convert. After it's done converting, you'll hit this download icon and then click the link. Here is your Webm file. To download it, you'll hit these three dots and then click download. After choosing your export folder, this file can not only be uploaded to Stream Elements and Streamlabs, but it can also be placed back inside of OBS to take up a smaller percentage of your GPU/CPU. Right now we have our .mov file running. If I switch this to our just downloaded Webm file, exact same spot, and now we are running a less hardware bearing file that causes lag and other things while you are streaming. All right, thank y'all so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you found this enjoyable, helpful, well, I'm not even asking for a like. Guess what? I'm gonna be making more of these really soon for games like Overwatch and Warzone. If you guys have any games that you'd like me to make one of these for, I would be happy to take suggestions. All of it will be free in my little Google Drive links that will be free downloads, no ads, no anything. One more thing, streaming DMCA safe is my playlist that I have created and I've had ever since I started streaming, stopped streaming, and now here we are. The playlist has grown to almost 10,000 followers and it is a one press and go for a full 80 hours. So it will run your course for any subathon that you're doing or any small stream that you're doing. You'll always be listening to different music. No more having to switch playlists, switch music. It's all in one spot. That is also listed in the description below. And if you guys have any questions, please feel free to join the Discord. Ask me anything, and I'll be willing to help. Thank y'all so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.